Attitude Tech Bronco Pride, and we're here today live from the Felton J. Capel Arena. We have a good one today, and it is the Federal State University Broncos going up against Elizabeth City State University Vikings. I'm Travis Bledsoe on the long side. Beside me is Coach of the Year in 2014, Mr. Alfonso Key. How's it going, Coach?
I'm doing great. I'm big CIAA asking today to state institutions. On a beautiful Saturday in Capel Arena. It's going to be an exciting battle.
Definitely an exciting battle today that we have. Hey, look, it's always good to come back to your alma mater, right?
It is.
Your alma mater, you graduated a long time before I graduated.
You got to say a long time ago, but I'll say it before you, no question.
Before you, right?
Exactly. Had a chance to be as a student, assistant coach, and a head coach. So special place for me.
Absolutely, man. And to say that it is still considered winter break, we got a nice turnout here. It's Community Month for Federal State going on right now, so it's going to be a beautiful day. Definitely. So look, we're going to get the starting lineups in and the national anthem, and we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.
Happy New Year. Welcome to Felton J. Capel Arena on the campus of Fayetteville State University, home of the Broncos. We'd like to remind all fans that smoking is not permitted anywhere inside the arena, and we thank you for your cooperation. Please take a moment to locate the nearest exit to your seat. All exits are illuminated with red signs and should be used to exit the building in the event of an emergency. Please exit in an orderly fashion and move away from the building once outside. During your stay, please note your fellow fans. If you see someone in medical distress, please notify the nearest security guard or campus police. For your convenience, our concession stands are located near the main entrance and the right corner of the concourse level. Restrooms are located near each concession stand. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask that you please rise as we honor the United States in the playing of the national anthem. Meet today's starting lineups first for the visiting Vikings of Elizabeth City State University. And forward, a 6'5 junior from Greenville, North Carolina, Mary number 1, John Mayer. And guard, a 5'11 sophomore from Waldorf, Maryland, wearing number 2, J. Justin.
And we're back with Travis Bledsoe and the coach, Alfonso Keys. So, Coach Keys, what are the keys for the game today?
Well, before we get in the games, I see some familiar faces. This is a great crew tonight as far as the refereeing staff. The referee is tonight Tony Wisnap. Official one is Jonathan Rumley. Official two is Timothy McClain. And neutral observer, Donnell Leathers. These are the, I guess, the officiators of the game. And as good as they are, as good as the game will be. But the keys tonight, this is kind of an odd environment because the kids aren't here, but it's a very important game for both teams. Off of Fayetteville State, you got to keep that momentum off a humongous Division I win against UNC Asheville.
And talking, that's a big win.
Talking to Coach Spencer, he really wants the key on boxing out tonight. Last game, they lost to ECSU and they gave up 20 offensive rebounds. That's the key, as well as defend the paint. And thirdly, he really wants to make sure they take their time and get great shots on offense and execute. And as far as ECSU, they want to take care of the basketball. Get back in transition deep because Fayetteville State is very good at transition. They want to rebound the ball as well. So they have both three keys talking to both coaches. Trying to make narrow it down. Those three things, they feel those things tonight can be accomplished. They have a great opportunity to win.
Absolutely. Look, right now I'm noticing that Fayetteville State right now is 0-3 in the conference. What do they need to do to get back into the running of things?
Well, I'll tell you one thing that the break has afforded Fayetteville State. They've added some talent. Joshua Bryan is back, and you know him. He is an elite downhill player in the league. That's a kind of an all-conference caliber guy you have on your roster at the semester. Then also has the Division I transfer at the point guard position. Richmond played at UNC Wilmington, Wilmington, State. So when you bring intact guys like that for the first time over the break, it changes the roster. So I think they'll help them tremendously.
Absolutely. And I also see that Jaquel Richmond also played for Chris Paul's CP3 All-Stars in AAU, man. That's a big thing right there.
It is, especially because he's playing the point guard position. So he comes with a reputation and some cachet, and I think he's going to make us better. And Coach Spencer alluded to the last game at UNC Asheville. He was a big part of that win.
Absolutely. That's a huge win against a Division I opponent in UNC Asheville. I don't care how people look at it. It's like, well, it's not Chapel Hill. It doesn't matter. It's a Division I team.
And they're on the road. So, you know, this is a game of momentum, a season of momentum. I think Coach Spencer is doing a lot better, adding that talent during the break and getting a big win. So right now, they want to know as far as their mind's concerned.
Absolutely. So right now, I want to get into the starting lineup. First, for Elizabeth City State University, you have John Mayer, Justin Faison, Shaquique Daniels, Joseph Allen, and Orlando Robinson. And for your Fayetteville State University Broncos, you have Jaquel Richmond, Raymond Pratt, Denzel Hodge, Joshua Bryant, and Giles Webster. Look, it's going to be a good game. Both well coached. Fayetteville State is being coached by Coach Ken Spencer, and the Vikings are coached by Sean Walker. Time to get off, man. Let's go.
I tell you what, Coach Sean Walker, this is unique. He's coming back again. This is his second stint at ECSU. So he's an alum, elite player, was a great coach there. Now his first year coming back for the second time.
Way to get on the floor on that one. Josh Bryant from the corner. Three is good.
Well, that's a positive sign. I think the official little taunting going on. That was a nice three he hit, but I think he turned around and said something to the bench. So making sure they're squared away. Initially with some good sportsmanship. Set the tone early.
Substitution into the game for the Broncos, number 13, Mark.
Well, he's excited to be back. You talk about an all-conference guy had to sit out, and he's back.
Absolutely.
And hit his first three and has some excitement, but has to keep his composure.
Feels
and stands
good.
A 40-minute game. Exactly.
Feels good, man. And to get those early jitters out the way, especially at a home team, too.
A little pressure by Fayetteville State. I think it's more to kind of control the clock a little bit. Took about 7 or 6 off the clock on that 1-2-2, three-quarter press.
I like what I'm seeing early. Right now, Robinson has the ball. Being pressured early by Denzel Hodge.
Well, good
a little
job.
Hesitation.
Fayetteville State came in because they came back and stayed in the zone. So I think a little confusion by the point guard. He thought their man had to change the play midstream and kind of hurt them as far as execution.
Exactly. There's a foul.
Vikings foul on number two, Justin Faison. That's his first team first.
That'll be the Vikings' first team foul. Faison's first foul.
I think Coach Spencer was pleased that first possession by them being in three-quarter court. It slowed. Mm-hmm. Stayed up, and by the time they got over the clock, they kind of went show what defense they're in. So sometimes you press and speed people up. Other times you press to kind of get them uneasy.
On the line for the Broncos, number 10, Denzel Hosh has one shot.
One thing that you did mention that they did make them uneasy, they looked off balance that time.
Yes. It's a game of runs and a game of getting people doing what they're not doing at their best.
And they're going back with the press.
Again, just trying to hold you up. It's a preventive press. Allow, good job, allow steals.
They're going back up. Another offensive rebound and a foul is called. Loving the hustle from the Broncos early. Especially from Josh Bryant. You see the smile on his face, man.
Oh, he's excited again. He got subbed in and subbed out. But he's elite in transition. He gets the ball in the open court. It's hard to defend him. And that's one thing, talking to Coach Sean Walker, he wanted to make sure they did is get back on defense and give up no bucks in transition as well as boxing now. So those possessions right there, I'm pretty sure they're disappointed.
Absolutely. Have to make those free throws. That's the second missed free throw from the Broncos already. See, the second one is up. And it is no good as well. The Broncos still with the lead 4-0 over the Vikings.
Okay, the Fayetteville State, even on the missed free throw, stayed in that three-quarter press. It's been effective thus far.
And rims out. No good for number 5, Shaquif Daniels. The senior out of Greenville, North Carolina. Went to Dudley High School, historic high school out there in Greenville. Oh, Conley, I'm sorry. That's Conley, not Dudley. Split the defense.
Oh,
goes
that's a
in.
Nice move.
I love that move.
Well, you're watching that basket. I was yesterday at practice and watched Coach Walker talk about specifically do not let them split on the ball screen. I know he's upset again. And that's Richmond, a veteran guard. You said been a few places. AAU with Chris Paul. You saw his pace and change direction and split that. Ball screen. It's funny watching these coaches prepare. Last night, watching Sean Walker, they went over that directly. He said no splits against the ball screen. So that's part of the chess game both teams are playing. Follow the game plan.
It happened, though. I'm pretty sure he's not happy about that, especially that's one of the keys he wanted to stop yesterday, as you saw in practice. First free throw was good for Joseph Allen. Second one's up, and it's also good. Prince scored 6-2. Broncos are still up.
Nice stroke by the left-hander.
Oh, I got a special love for the lefties too, man. And a strong move, no good, but goes back up. No foul being called, but the Vikings are back on offense, pushing it.
Present in transition.
And herself. A layup. Good for Joseph Allen.
Well, you see a little pressure here by the Vikings. Return in favor.
Dumped down low and no good.
Looking at press, sped them up a little bit compared to Fayetteville State's press. Got a shot a little too quick and uneasy. Carried the basketball. Called a traveling call.
Possession goes to the Broncos.
Traveling call. Possession goes to the Broncos.
Well, I have a different perspective on these coaches, seeing these guys prepare and give their players the answers and come in the game and do the opposite sometimes a little frustrating. That's why coaches always seem to talk loud with aggressive counseling because they've given the players the answer and sometimes they don't follow through, but it's going to be an outstanding game today. Side ball screen, Fayetteville State. Much better job covering it.
They're trying to get it down low, but Webster comes up with the screen.
Well, Fayetteville State runs good action.
6 seconds left. and a strong take from Joshua Bryan.
Quick timeout by Coach Walker. Disappointed by the penetration again given up by Josh Bryan.
So while we have a moment, too, for all the up-to-date information about Fayetteville State Athletics, visit the official FSU Athletics website at www.fsubroncos.com. Also, keep up with FSU Athletics on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at FSU Broncos, as well as on Instagram at FSU_Broncos. I follow them personally on everything social media that I have, man, so I'm definitely up-to-date as well. It's good to have you in the building, though, Coach Key.
Oh, you're too kind. You're too kind. It's a great place to be. Shout out to basketball. Again, watching these guys practice. Just great basketball, great teaching by both staff, and some Lynch and 6'11 kids. So it's very underrated, the level of basketball here in the Shadow Blade. But great place. The facility is gorgeous. The floor is redone.
I was about to say, did you notice the floor?
I noticed everything. I think my first year playing was the first year Capable Arena was open. So it means something to me.
Let's get back started. The Vikings have the ball. Robinson looking to penetrate.
I know that timeout by Coach Walker was purposely to make sure they did a better job of guarding the ball screen action and protecting the paint. Offensive rebound was disappointed by Coach Spencer. Creating shots at the third one of the possession.
And a foul is called on Raymond Pratt.
Technical foul on number four, Raymond Pratt. That's his on first that, team second.
On that defensive possession, it looked like that the Broncos were just a little frantic on there trying to get back because there was a couple of people who cheated and tried to get the steal, and it left people open to get the offensive rebound.
Well, no question. You got to be solid.
Joseph Allen with the score. Pulls the Vikings within two. The score is 8-6. 16-12 remaining in the first half. Richmond with it. You see, he wants to score. Dumps off to Webster. And a
good action. Good action. Coach Spencer's offense in transition is hard to guard. A lot of actions you must defend. You know,
like
this is one
two,
sitting.
That's
Coach Spencer's offense may have a dribble handoff, a side ball screen, a cross screen, a pass screen, and a backdoor cut. So you got to be prepared to guard all that each possession. So it's extremely important that you're locked in and focused. And if you're not, you give up a bucket.
One thing that I did like from Webster that I like is it goes unnoticed sometimes is that his hands were ready for the pass.
Yes, and again, they do a great job in practice. Coach Spencer and his staff, they're very detailed on their offense and their actions and routine. So I've seen this run over and over again, so it becomes second nature. But he's definitely basketball ready. A couple subs by the Broncos.
I love it. We have number 13, Mark Burton. He's coming in the game. He started off the season, a great three-point shooter as well. Can't leave him open. And also, you have number 33, Marquise Crutchfield, in the game as well.
I tell you, Lynchburg State, they're aggressive on the backcourt. You know, when the shot is up, their forwards really attack the basket. Fayetteville State has to do a better job of putting their body in front of them. And again, Coach Spence, that's one of his facts for the game. So it's not a surprise. He talked about it, discussed it. He must execute it.
Right now, Lynchburg State is leading on their boards right now by 2-7-5. Oh, with the crossover, Burton, and he knocks down the three. I like that.
He's a dynamic shooter. He's hitting off the bounce and off the catch. And that last possession, though, they switched the ball screen. They made an adjustment by Sean Walker. So it's fun to watch the chess game.
Now, when I see someone cross somebody up like that and they hit the floor, I think the shot should just automatically go in for them. Like, the basketball guys should just allow it to just go in. And that's what they did for Mark Burton.
A lot of times, the guy falls down by accident, but it looks good.
Yeah. Definitely makes it look better.
But they're impressed with Burton's touch. He's coming all the way from Tokyo, Japan. Fayetteville State that he reaches around the world. I'm basketball players. By way of Park Atlanta.
Absolutely. That foul was on Joseph Valor. And while we have time right now, too, students, parents, fans, and alumni can now represent their favorite CIAA team, FSU Broncos, by purchasing exclusive gear at BroncosFanshop.com. BroncosFanshop.com offers a variety of Fayetteville State merchandise, from athletic apparel and jewelry to pet accessories and tailgating supplies. For discounts and promotions, visit BroncosFanshop.com today.
Well, the Broncos are up 12-10. It's been a back-and-forth game. Josh O'Brien, an impact player. Him just being here already has 5 points. Attack the basket, making things happen.
All right, let's hear it from Darryl.
What FSU needs to do when it takes a semester, just add better players on the team. I really like the way Sean Walker and his staff are switching the ball screens. They made a mistake early, called a timeout, and corrected that. So both coaches are doing a great job with their chess game.
Absolutely. You love to see a back-and-forth chess match between two great coaches. I know that for a fact.
Yeah, so much that is behind the scenes and preparing for opponents that the average IWC is exciting for me to watch as a fan and a former coach.
Now, I want to say, you still coach to me.
Yeah, I'm always coach. I'm former collegiate coach, yeah.
Yeah,
happily coached at K-3 High School with some great young men out there.
Right now, y'all doing well, too, at 9-3 here.
You're doing okay. You too kind.
Definitely had to catch a game one day, man, when my cousin's not playing for the JV team for K-2.
More than happy. More than happy to.
As we get back into the action with the Broncos having the ball and the lead as well, 12-10, with 14:45 remaining in the game. Burton up for another three is no good.
Well, he's a guy you must locate. He's good to shoot the ball with range.
Dump down to 21-21 open for three, and it is good. Shaheed Petway gives the Vikings their first lead of the game.
Another stat we'll look forward to, who wins the turnover battle as far as who's least and who wins the rebounding battle. I know that's a big issue for the Vikings, that rebounding battle.
A step back jumper is no good for Richmond, but Broncos sticks with the ball.
Well, Richmond is just a smooth operator. She's controlled and has a dynamic range of offensive moves, and he can run the offense.
I love his move. I love the way he moves, too. Burton coming off, looking to score. Richmond in the corner for three, and is short.
Mississippi State was guarding that baseline out of bounds defense in the man-to-man. Ball reversal is outstanding.
Three is up. Shaquille Daniels with a three. Back-to-back threes for the Vikings.
Well, I thought allowed that was just ball reversal. They ran the rim and spread the floor, ball moved from side to side. Here's that ball screen with Josh O'Brien, so effective. Penetrating pitch, creating play for his teammate. It's a good shot, he knows he misses, it's a good shot. Now Brown checking the game, he has some impact on the glass, hopefully. Good defense by the Broncos.
Way to be there for Richmond.
This is a key part of the game, can you stop Josh O'Brien in transition?
And another missed three, a
good rebound.
Rebound
by Will Brown.
Falls out of bounds. Possession remains to the Broncos. Into the game for the Broncos, number 12, Jacob Crutchfield.
Well, you just see, so impressive, just kind of harping on Ryan. He just impacts the game. By him being able to penetrate and make plays for himself or others, it changes the Fayetteville State's whole offensively dynamic. But I know it's big on Coach Spencer's mind. He really wants his guys to execute and get great shots, not good shots.
Foul was called on Omar Roberts.
Vikings foul on number 13.
First meeting timeout. The Vikings have taken the lead 16-12. Here's some more substitutions by the Broncos. Number 11, Rivers, is coming in. He's definitely an offensive fire starter. He can shoot the ball off the catch, off the bounce, and make some plays. So he's an exciting guy to watch.
Definitely a microwave type player, man. And not afraid of any shot. And you can see him right now about to take the three, and he knew it was short. And strong rebound by Crutchfield. Going up. Shot blocked. Broncos stick with the ball.
Yeah, Crutchfield's another impressive looking specimen. Physical around the basket, naturally aggressive, and he's going to help the Broncos as well down this stretch. And you also talk about another freshman came in. Other Crutchfield, 12, a point guard. So Coach is really building his program the right way. Has a great mix of junior college kids, high school kids, and transfers.
Definitely love that mix. And it's way too many steps. And you talk about the coach building the team. That's one of the main things you definitely want to have.
Have a plan and have pieces in place to execute that plan. And just looking at the roster overall, most of these kids will be back next year. This is going to be a nice finish for the year for the Broncos and leading them next year. Guys are getting this culture. People understand it takes time when you take over a program to get everybody thinking like you, talking like you, believing like you, and bringing players in and meshing personalities. And I'll tell you, he does a great job outside. Talking to him the other day, you know, we have eight guys on the Broncos with a GPA of 3.0.
Wow.
Or better. And that's
putting
the main
academics
deal.
First.
No question.
And I'm looking at the roster as well. There's only two seniors on this team, so yeah.
Exactly. You see them grow this year and be ready to roll next year as well. Now, it's some size. It's about a Division II basketball game. Two 6'11 kids out here. Number 20 checked in for the Vikings. He's a transfer out of Morgan State University.
Oh, yeah, he's a good, long, linky player, man, but definitely has some length.
So it's nice to see South AA basketball, two 6'11 kids that can run and jump, change the game from the defensive end.
It's a luxury.
It is. He's a good athlete, too, not just big kids walking around the basket.
Not at all. And I'm looking, Nakia Rivers right there, and that's the guy I was looking for, and the three is off. I tell you, he hasn't seen a shot that he doesn't like.
Oh, no, he knows his job. It's an immediate offense. Oh, that's a nice move. Good.
Up and under move, yeah. Man. I love it. From Tajay Byers. Hope I said his name right.
He did. Byers and Brown. I said this is two good NCAA big men. It's fun to watch. Watch these guys grow. Next 2 years battling each other.
Right now, the Vikings are on an 8-0 run.
And Jacob
Crutchfield ends that 8-0 run right there.
He's a good-looking freshman.
Yeah.
Point guard and distributor to make the open shot.
And three.
That's three.
Another three for the Vikings. Shaheed Petaway, I believe that's his second three-point made.
Both of these threes, I like them both ends of the court. It's because of good offense. Guys reversing the ball, penetrating pitching.
And Crutchfield's up for the three, and it's no good. The Broncos are not hitting their threes right now. And a good defense by Burton.
Substitute for the Vikings, you have Hobbs come in. He's an impact player who's been out, I think, with injury since the Catawba game. And Coach Sean Walker's very high on him. You know, he has not had his team together all year with injuries and sitting out. And so, you know, he's still trying to find some chemistry, and he feels very strong when they find it. Kind of similar as well as with Coach Spencer, two or three guys added a semester. So guys are still trying to find themselves.
Absolutely.
Dribble handoff, switch by Fayetteville State.
They're taking some time off the clock. There's 6 seconds left on the shot clock, so they have to get something going. And that three is up, and it is good. The Vikings are on fire from three-point land
right
now.
Yeah, I watched Hobbs yesterday in practice. He's a playmaker. He can make shots, and he can make his own play for himself and others. Stagger screen down for the Broncos. Good execution. Ball side to side.
And Nakia Richard. There we go. Nakia Rivers in a fadeaway shot is no good. And great defense by Nakia Rivers.
Right after getting back defensively, not hanging his head on the miss.
Didn't foul or anything.
Media timeout.
Let me say, keep chopping that wood.
So what do the Broncos have to do to get back into this game?
Well, I think they get some quality shots, but they miss some shots. And I think Coach Spence will kind of want that balance. There's a minor three being open, but let's get the ball inside a little bit, either through post-up or penetration.
And a lot of made threes by the Vikings, so what do the Broncos have to do to defensively to stop that?
Well, I think the threes, they kind of ebb and flow, but what really hurts you are the paint points. I think you saw an up and under move by Byers in the paint. You saw three offensive rebounds at a time. So, you know, the three-pointers, they'll fade at times, but if you keep giving up paint opportunities, it's going to be tough. And also, you talk about field goal percentage. Right now, the Vikings are shooting 60%, which is extremely high. Too bad we stayed at 27%, 5 for 18, 2 for 8, but 3 for 9. So, you're going to get better shots. You're not getting bad shots, but when other team is hot, you're going to get great shots.
Absolutely. The game is still early, though. The Broncos could definitely get back into the game. Down by 10 right now, 24-14, with 9:41 remaining in the first half.
Well, you want to, Coach Prince, as a coach, you're not concerned right now about the score as much as how you're playing. There's some things you want it done, rebound the basketball and getting back on defense. So you just kind of solve those issues minute by minute, and then we'll see what happens later part of the game.
All right, as you get back to the action.
Oh, got a little running jump here by the Vikings.
And a nice cut and a missed
great
layup.
Fast, but a missed layup. Got to leave him like that.
Jumpers off.
Falls out of bounds. Possession remains to the Vikings.
They're getting great shots, though. Great looks. It's just not executing.
That's why the defense and the rebound are so imperative, because shots, you have no idea what they're going to make sometimes. Also, free throw line, Fayetteville State's 2-for-6.
And a blocking foul is called on Giles Webster on that one.
Bronco foul number 21, Giles Webster. That's his first, team third.
Shaheed Petway will go to the line for two. Strong
on the
drive
line,
by Petway.
Two for the Vikings, number 21, Shaheed Petway.
So Fayetteville State's doing a positive job in reference to taking care of the basketball. 2 turnovers of 6 for the Vikings.
Definitely great. Definitely doing a good job defensively as far as getting the turnovers go and not committing turnovers as well on the offensive side. But they have to make those layups. I've seen, I believe, that's like their third or fourth missed layup.
And right now, percentage-wise, you're shooting 27% approximately from the field and 33% or so from the free throw line. So I tell you, Coach Walker's doing a great job of changing defenses. Going from the man, now a little running jump pressure. Now a little zone work, three-quarter court. So, have more balance right now. But Coach Prince does a great job of having sets and answers to this pressure.
And I see that Jaquel Richmond, he just ran the ball up the court, not even giving the press time to set up.
Vikings foul number 5, Shaquille.
Got a good set. Coach ran for Jeremy Williams, an isolation on the elbow. Got a chance to get a blocking foul. So we also another way to score and compete. Come back and run and get to the foul line in the bonus. Getting close.
Trying to get the ball inbounded.
It's a hold by Maynard. I think Maynard's a local product.
Vikings foul number 1, John Maynard.
Yeah, Northwood Temple,
that's
right down the street on Ramsey Street.
Originally from Rayford, yeah. So there's some hometown feel. A lot of good basketball players on both ends from the state of North Carolina. And then we have one as far as Tokyo. So
oh, wow.
There's some diversity here on this court.
Mark Burton, yeah, from Tokyo.
This is a way for the Broncos. Well, good set again, Randall. He's been before with isolation. But now we get a chance to get to the free throw line, shoot 1-1, and chip away at this lead.
Have to make this free throw. And miss free throw.
Well, he's a better shooter, he's showing. It's a matter of relaxing and focusing. Free throw is an enigma at times for all coaches and players.
Great defensive play by Haas.
Yeah, Haas has been quiet offensively. Got to find a better way of getting him the basketball. We could be effective, but love him to compete defensively.
Denzel Haas is one of those players that you can see the intensity in his face along with his play as well. Good hands from Bryant. And Richmond taking it all the way.
He's effective in transition. I think Fayetteville State, that's one of his strengths. When they get the rebound or turnover, they do a great job of converting on the far end. And that's one of the keys that Coach Walker talked about, is making sure they're getting back in transition.
Brings the score to 28-16. The Broncos are down by 12 with 8:10 remaining in the game.
A little matchup switching defense by the Broncos. Been effective.
And strong rebound brought down by Webster. Brian with it. Richmond has it.
gets the screen from Webster.
A perimeter foul, which is extremely difficult for the Vikings, because walk over and stomp his feet, because again, you're 30 feet from the basket, and by that foul, the Broncos get a chance to get an opportunity to shoot the free throw. So I think that's the way we got to think about it, get back in the game.
And they're in the 1-1 early, too. 7:47, and then a couple more fouls, they're in the double bonus.
And now if you're Fayetteville State, you really want to be aware of the bonus. So if you're in the bonus now, you kind of want to keep driving the basketball. Even though you're missing, you still keep attacking and get to the foul line and score the ball with the clock not moving.
Now, as a former coach, the next practice, will free throws be a main topic, a main point that you're going over?
It will, but at the same time, I'm proud you get to the foul line, so that's a win in itself. So you want to keep encouraging guys to get there and just keep working and relaxing, man. You know, all over the country, it's hard to figure out. LeBron's on a streak right now in the NBA as far as, and Westbrook are missing free throws, so you got to keep working at it and relax. Westbrook and Bryant, well, those guys are leading transition.
Broncos are within 10 now. 7 minutes remaining in the game in the half. The corner three is no good, and strong rebound.
Offensive rebound.
Bronco foul on number two, Xavier Williams. That's his first, team fourth. On the line shooting two for the Vikings, number 20, Tyjae Myers.
Tyjae Myers is a 69% free throw shooter. And the first one is off.
Well, you saw the defense by the Broncos. And you always talk about the coach and all your defensive possessions ending in the rebound. All that work we're engaged without blocking out. But Byers is an impressive, long athletic transfer from Morgan State. I had a chance to see him play as a freshman, and I was a fan of
you. Possession remains to the Broncos.
He looks like a very athletic guy. You get him out in the transition. I like to see him throw it down one
time. Yeah, so he's a very good defensive. Good high post action, ball reversal, diagonal screen.
And you see Byers' length coming into play right there, too.
Yeah. Bad foul by Fayetteville State right there. Doing a good job. They're doing a good job defending, but you know, you don't want to get the Vikings in the bonus. Doing a good job not fouling the team fifth foul. So we're going to keep playing aggressive before we get seven.
Because he's
still trying to mesh. You add three guys, that's a mess. You know, he has some pieces out here. And you want to be good at the end.
Absolutely. Definitely has some big pieces, too.
The chemistry is hard. Good rotation.
Still by Richmond.
Ball screen. Coverage. Good flash.
And a three from the top of the key is good for Richmond.
High level basketball. They're good basketball players out here. He's impressive.
The Broncos are within single digits now. Down by 8, 29-21. 6 minutes remaining in the half. And the top of the key three is no good. Byers with the rebound. Byers just has the right position, and that length is killing the Broncos right now.
Xavier Williams, that's his second.
So Spencer, I'm shaking his head because I saw him directly.
Substitution into the game for the Broncos, number four,
rebounding and blocking out as a key. And
number 33, Crutchfield.
Where they're going to
compete on the backboard.
So they'll do what they've been told. No matter getting it done.
And absolutely, and even if he is taller than you, boxing out definitely shortens the player, in my opinion.
A lot of times you want to block out just to take the guy out of the rebound position. Exactly. He's going to get it.
And another turnover for the Broncos. Let's see if they can score off this one. And a three is up for Denzel Hoskins. It's good.
Red by the turnover. Opportunity again, but Fayetteville State did a good job by changing pace, by causing turnovers. They can make some free throws combined with turning them over, get a chance to really make a run. Again, a foul on semi-on the perimeter, allowing the Vikings to get two more opportunities on 1-1.
Free throws up. Yeah. No good. The Broncos are within five.
Ball screen, they split the ball screen. Missed and a shot, but got to the paint.
Bryant looking for a foul call on that one. And corner three is up and no good for Petway.
By another rebound. Out of turnover, unfortunately, failed to take force on that rebound. Slipped on the baseline.
Substitution to the game for the Vikings, number one, John Maynard.
Both coaches did a great job of substituting.
Media timeout.
Fresh.
Once again, it's time for the Broncos fan of the game.
And there is a media timeout. And while we have the time as well, too, you can be ahead of the game and purchase your 2019 CIAA basketball tournament tickets from the Fayetteville State University ticket offer. You're invited to the CIAA's most anticipated event. Tickets for the 2019 CIAA men's and women's basketball tournament are on sale now at Fayetteville State University ticket offer. The annual event will once again be held in Charlotte, North Carolina, the Queen City, from February 25th to March 2nd. 2019. I can't wait for the CIAA tournament, man.
Well, I look forward to being there. It's going to be a very competitive event.
All right, let's hear
both these teams that we see right now, I think they'll be much better. When we see the fans, of course, the addition of the domestic players from Fayetteville State, trying to mesh them with chemistry. Same with the Vikings. You know, he has three guards, hadn't played together all year. Hobbs is one of those guys in facing, and Sean Walker excited to see when everybody's together. How good they could be.
One thing too that about the CIAA tournament is that the records really don't matter at that point. It's almost like it's a new season, seems like.
It is a new season. You know, in life, you understand the process of maturation and month and year to day get better. For some reason, we think that athletes are the same way. These teams are getting better every day. They're maturing, they're learning, so I look forward to a competitive tournament. I look forward to being there.
Can't wait, can't wait. And we're back to the action. Broncos have cut the lead down to five. It's down by as many as 14 at one point. And Crutchfield loses the ball.
Pulls out of bounds.
Well, ECSU comes out of man-to-man. Crutchfield tried to make a move to the basket and thought he turned it over.
Substitution into the game for the Broncos. The just
discussing about the call. I guess it's Broncos ball. I guess deflection off a Viking.
That's what it looked like. I thought he just lost it.
Yeah.
Oh, looked like, wow, John Maynard probably got away with a push on that one, too.
Side ball screen, having going to defend it. Heads. Drop back.
And the steal from the Vikings. Number five, Shaquille Daniels. Corner three is up, and it is.
It's a push by 13.
Push. And that was sending the Broncos to the line once again.
Vikings foul on number 13, Omar Roberts. That's his second, team ninth.
Going to the line for two is Raymond Pratt.
When you think about it, all of the scoring and the missed shots, but the Broncos
Raymond Pratt
just capitalize on these free throw opportunities, they would have the lead right now.
Absolutely.
Because when you miss a one-on-one, I mean, that's basically losing two shots and equate to a turnover. Basically, it's a turnover.
And that's their seventh missed free throw at this point. So, two for nine, that's not good at all.
Well, the positive is they're getting there, and you got to hope, you got to know that they'll make it, so hope sooner than later.
And a corner three is up, and it is no good again. The Vikings are definitely going cold from the three-point line.
Tough foul by the Vikings.
Vikings foul on number 22, Joseph Allen. That's his third, team 10. On the line shooting two for the Broncos,
see,
number 10.
Here's Coach Sean Walker getting on his player, on his big man for fouling out there. Two silly fouls.
These coaches, they put everything into it. They got great staffs, and like I said, this Coach Walker's second stint. with the Vikings, and he has on his staff some guys that were there previously with him. Lou Grimsley, a veteran coach out of a high school coach out of New Jersey that's won multiple state championships. And also he has a new guy on his staff that carried over, that Dwayne Saunders, that's been head coach at the community level. So new staffs are preparing, and this eat, sleep, and drink and stuff.
Yeah. It's their life right here. Tajay Byers put the Vikings up by 7 with that score. Crutchfield turnaround jumper is good.
Rascal, I think he's going to be a factor as he gets comfortable in the second semester. The staff is excited about him. Big body, physical, nice touch.
That man looks like a running back out there.
He
man,
does. He's well built.
Oh, well, his size at 6'5", he'd probably be more of a defensive end coming off the edge. And still from Hot, his intensity is taking it all the way to miss the layup. And Hot gets back on defense. Way to stay there. Great defense by the Broncos. Well, that, not panicking.
They're active, and that's been their strength this half, is creating turnovers.
Pull-up jumper is good.
That's good.
Number 13, Omar Roberts. 2:35 remaining in the first half. The Broncos are down by 5.
Elevated screen for the shooter. Good coverage.
Bert is looking for the screen from Crutchfield.
Good coaches here. Good offenses and a three is up. Good defenses.
And a three is no good. From Richmond. And three is up for Hobbs, no good as well. The Vikings have really gone cold.
They have, but they continue to appear on the backboard, and that's why the game ebbs and flows. You gotta relax. And Coach Spence has been here, done that. You gotta keep chopping away. Coach Spencer also has a tremendous staff with Ray Rodden over there and Sean McCain. These guys work real hard, and Ray Rodden with basketball acumen has been high school, AAU. All over, but he has a military background as well.
To the game for the Broncos, number 20, Joshua Ryan. The
program has some structure. And Sean McCain doing a great job as well.
On the line, shooting the Broncos for the Vikings, number 5,
operations and, you know, coaching is as important as team is having chemistry.
Absolutely. Tell us about what goes into the process of recruiting.
Well, I'll tell you what, number one is you got to fit and know what type of program you have and type of player you want, type of student athlete. And then once you identify what fits in your system, you have to go all out and something like CIA and investigate and build relationships and,
yeah,
from the high school coaches, the AAU coaches, the barbers, the pastors, and relationships. And then you hopefully kind of get them early.
Absolutely.
1 year to the next, and hopefully you get your brand set up yourself. The well, these guys work in 12 months a year, recruiting and teaching and community.
On the line, shooting plus one for the Broncos.
It's nice to see both staffs, quality role models for these young people out here. People forget that. You know, you talk about quality men. And statistics say a lot of young people don't have fathers in their lives, and these two coaches and staff do a great job of being that while they're here.
Absolutely. It goes definitely something that's underrated, that goes unnoticed sometimes, but you can tell in the players.
That's the important part of coaching, is teaching and leading young people the right way.
And Byers again on the board.
Played above the rim, but because it was penetration. 4-point game.
A minute 23 remaining, and the three is up by Haas. No good. They're getting down on the floor.
And you want him to keep taking good shots because he's capable at any time to get hot. A lot of times coaches, good fans, they want to see the quality of shot. If it's an open shot, keep shooting and make a miss of the fall compared to 4 shots.
They don't like that call on Crutchfield. I think I have to agree with Coach Spencer on that one.
I think I always agree with
the
coach. I don't know that.
For the Vikings, number 21, Shaheen Petaway.
Shaheen Petaway will go to the free throw line for a 1-1.
But Coach Spencer knows that he's just a possession away a block out away, a free throw away of having this lead. So everything counts. It's imperative.
Minute 10 left remaining in the first half. Broncos are down by four.
The Broncos are playing small now. Got four perimeter guys that can make shots, and three guys in the driver.
1 minute.
Field, dynamic forward.
Burton open for three. He takes it, and it's good.
Three.
Under a minute remaining, and the Broncos are down by one, 35-34.
Look at you, one-point game. All that transition and difference of scores, tied and lead, one-point game, under a minute. That's why you keep playing, be composed, and be consistent.
Petway up for a three, and it's no good. With 26 seconds remaining, the Broncos calling timeout.
Timeout was called. I'm not sure if that was in the right spot where Coach wanted a timeout, but big possession here, 23 seconds to get a quality shot.
Definitely, and definitely one shot. So. The Broncos definitely could have bundled up early and wrapped it up, but they definitely fought back and brought this game back within one and have a chance to take the lead.
Now they played hard and intensely, but want to play hard and well. And free throw shooting could be improved as well as just defending the paint. But it makes an exciting game, just back and forth. Great job, both coaches.
Another big thing that I noticed, too, is that when the Vikings got hot from three-point land, they also went cold.
Yeah. Well, like I said, three-pointers are up and down. They're fluid. They're inconsistent. But the things you can do every day is defend, block out, take care of the basketball. So that's what coaches harp on. Shots ebb and flow.
Broncos still losing the rebound battle by eight.
Yes, that's key of the game right there, rebound the basketball.
And you definitely called it boxing out.
Yes. Yes. And the rebound is a process of after blocking out. You know, everybody can block out, everybody can't rebound.
Right.
Everybody can put a body on somebody.
Absolutely. 20 seconds remaining. The Broncos will hold for the last shot. What?
Well, they're in the zone defense and.
And Burton up for three is good. 5 seconds remaining.
Great job.
Still two.
Getting the quality shot for the guy that wants
it. Up. No good. And the Broncos take the lead into the first half. 37-35 over the Vikings right now.
Both coaches said it's going to be a battle. It's going to be close. And they know what they're talking about.
Definitely. They definitely know what they're talking about. And right now, we'll take a break too as the Broncos. Go up 37-35. We'll be right back.
For your convenience, our concession stands are located near the main entrance and the right corner of the concourse level. Restrooms are located near the concession stand.
I wonder if that Brian Kidd, I wonder if he related to George and Eric Mason.
I know he grew up in my neighborhood.
Right.
I know I grew up with his older sister.
When the music starts, each contestant must dribble the basketball over to the chair. Let me know, man.
You good.
The basket and make a shot.
This easy for me, man. It's your basketball expertise.
Down there.
I usually go upstairs, though, to this corner over here.
Our contestants this evening, Bryce Bennett, Antoine Diggins, Christian Willow, DeAndre Hargrove, Tyree Freeman, and Jamari
right when
Freeman.
Half about to start.
Are you ready for musical chairs? DJ.
That's what I got to show you. New Year's.
Who's that? Man, your daughter is.
Yes, it is.
How you doing, Dad? How you doing, Dad? What's up, Dad? How you doing?
I told her. She said when you coming up here. Repeat.
All right, we have one listener. I believe that's Antoine Diggins.
You know she does. You know she does a podcast.
Yeah. Tell her I'll be up there soon.
And then they was full.
Be down there.
So I said, I ain't gotta come up and shoot nobody, right?
Nope. You ain't even got to say, hey, nope.
I will come up and shoot somebody.
I know you will. Quick.
I will come up and hurt somebody behind my door. Let me tell you something. Three throws are killing these boys, man.
Yeah. That should be up.
I'm going up to concession.
What do you think, man? I'm good, man. Yeah, appreciate you.
Get you on the bench. I don't know his name. What's his name?
See, they got a hot dog up there.
Let's say goodbye to Christian Miller. Tie those laces, son. And then they were spoiled. Musical chairs, sponsored by Coca-Cola. Who will be the winner? There could be only one.
Hey, he there yet?
You must
should have hit him up yesterday, man. I don't have to. Man, because these numbers, these are his. Yeah. And I knew I should have called him at work. Man, I'm at Felton State, man. Right now, calling the game. But as soon as it's over, man, I come. Come on, cool. You work at 4? Alright, man, this game over. It should be over by 2, man. So I should be there no later than 2. Alright.
Yeah.
about to. Heck yeah. I get there and then that's what? Probably what? Fox Sports, man. ACC there, ESPN, all that. Yeah. NASCAR though. Yeah, the NASCAR Hall of Fame down there. Right there. Yeah. Yeah. And all, not to mention all the high school sports like the prep and stuff down there. Yeah. What? They got a. Independent. You from Charlotte? I can tell. To the way you were talking about Charlotte like that. And then right outside of there is South Carolina. They got a lot of good sports out there too, man. So, yeah. Because next summer I'm trying to go to that Peach Jam, the high school tournament they have called the Peach Jam. That don't be like that, dog. I wanted to go to the John Wall tournament this last couple weeks. Yeah. Yeah. You said what? Yeah.
All right, and we're back live from the Felton J. Capel Arena, where we have the Elizabeth City State University Vikings going up against our favorite State University Broncos, and the Broncos are up by 2, 37-35, heading into the second half. Coach Key is with me, and I'm Travis Bledsoe. What do the Broncos need to do to continue to build on this lead and to go home with the W today against the Vikings?
I'll tell you, certainly both teams going in the half, coaches trying to solve some issues. The Broncos got to the free throw line, but free throw shooting has been disappointing. So we got to correct that issue. Free throw shooting right now is shooting 41%. And also, we got to defend the paint. The Vikings have 18 points in the paint. So those are two things you got to stop the paint opportunity and make free throws. All that being said, it's a two-point game. And going to the Vikings, I'm pretty sure Coach Walker talked about taking care of the basketball. They've had 13 turnovers that have resulted in the 12 points off turnovers for the Vikings. But both teams shot the ball from three pretty well, and it's a matter of who's going to solve the issue first. But Broncos take care of the free throw shooting, protect the paint, and a two-point game will be up to 10.
Absolutely. And we're getting started with the second half, and a foul is called.
With some big bodies down there, man. That's the first offensive possession. Sean Walker went inside, so that's a positive for the Vikings and negative for the Broncos. We talked about paint points is 18. Right now, the 10 Vikings.
And right now, Joseph Allen is going to the free throw line. Knocked out his first. Didn't see too much out of him in the first half. Stayed in foul trouble. Coach Walker was getting on him a lot.
Yes, he's definitely aggressive. And for the Vikings, also just pet away, led him scoring with 10 points. And balanced attack for the Broncos, 9 for Richmond and 9 for Barton. Sharp shooter. Josh Bryan added 8. So there's a balanced attack for the Broncos in the backcourt. Little pressure, 2-2-1. Pressure by the Vikings.
Can't wait for it. There you go.
Off that sideline. Again, a lot of times the objective is just to get time off the clock. So in the half court set, you have to guard the whole possession. Now, right now, Fayetteville State has 12 seconds left in the shot clock. So
gotta
they've
get
done
going.
Their job. Yep.
Bryant has it down the baseline. Turnaround jumper is
hard to guard up down there.
And it's no good. Definitely hard to guard down there.
It's a good set by Coach Spencer. I said he's one of the better players. Coach Walker makes immediate substitution.
Foul number 22, Joseph Allen. That's his fourth.
That's Joseph Allen's fourth foul.
Yes. I guess there was a misunderstanding. The foul is on Joshua Bryant.
Going over the bat. I was wondering what the call was, though, honestly, because it didn't look like it was over the bat, but it also didn't look like Joseph Allen fouled him at all either.
Correction, that last foul was on number 20, Joshua Bryant. That's his first, team second.
That's two early fouls, not even a minute left in the first half. I mean, second half, I'm sorry. Second half just started.
18:56 left.
Yeah. Two early fouls on the Broncos. The Broncos definitely have to be careful.
Oh, they tried to trap that corner and Fable State did.
A good duck down.
We talk about points in the paint. Points in the paint. Points in the paint.
Joseph Allen, a junior out of Miami Gardens, Florida, went to Miami Christian.
Another trap. Paint point right back at him. Very good. Very good.
Giles Webster with the score.
Impressive, both teams front court. Got some size, 6'8", with some strength to them as well, some long, 6'11", 6'10". So both teams done a great job recruiting. The town out here is pretty impressive.
Good defense from the Broncos. Losing the ball, almost had to steal. The Vikings get it back with 8 seconds left in the shot clock, and the layup is good.
And again, the layup being redundant, sounds like a broken record right now. That's another paint opportunity. So.
And a blocking foul.
Well, I really like the backcourt and the possibilities that Coach Spencer
has. Foul number one, John
they have dynamic guards, Bryant and Richmond. Very impressive. You have the shooter, Haas. So he's done a great job of bringing in talent.
Definitely. I love the guard play. And they have guards on the bench as well, and Burton and Rivers. And the freshman Crutchfield as well.
Just need some time. Need some time for this set. Almost like you're trying to cook something. I don't cook well, make sure I'm clear. Watch others. You know, stuff has to set and marinate overnight, and same with a program.
You're not good at cooking, man?
Not at all. I could put something in the microwave for 3:30.
Oh, yeah?
Pour it off.
Traveling.
They're talking to Coach Spencer. He wants to build something here long term.
Definitely.
And he's a guy who played at Pinecrest for a legendary lake. Coach Jeff Capel, so he's an area guy. Pembroke State is an awesome point guard there. Coach in Scotland County.
An easy layup miss.
Outstanding. Paint opportunity, though. He's tough.
Count the basket,
count the basket for Josh Bryant on that play right there. Stay with it. That's what I like when I see players right there. You miss a layup, but you don't anticipate the make. You go right back up quick. Second jump from Josh Bryant to get that possession. They go for the and one.
He's definitely a top guard in the shadow play when it comes to penetrating downhill and attacking the basket.
I remember seeing Joshua Bryant play in intramurals, and was wondering why he was playing intramurals. But
he's just sitting out temporarily. No, he's not an intramural guy.
No, not at all.
Well, three quarter press is the same as well for the Broncos. Kind of change gears.
Broncos are up 42-40 with 17 minutes remaining in the second half. I'm sorry. Three is up, no good.
So that's why you don't get enamored by the three-point shot. You'll make him miss.
But the Broncos have to do better on the defensive boards, though. The floater is good.
Another paint opportunity.
But Justin Fazer.
They do a good job in painting. Coach Walker talking about Fazer. Did a great job of stepping up when Hobbs is out and showed great ability to be a lead guard. Forward program.
Richmond taking it in and scoring. Good. Good back and forth game. The Broncos go back up by two.
Well, I know Coach Spence really likes Richmond, and he being a former point guard himself, so he has an eye for that. And this kid has the whole package. Smooth, to score, distribute, defend.
Top of the key, three is good. Three. Number five, Shaquise Daniels.
Exciting basketball on CIAA tonight. This is impressive today, excuse me.
Guard
play, shooting threes, playing with pace, bigs down finishing, concepts defensively.
Absolutely. The Vikings are up by one now. Ryan, you give him that lane, and he's going to go, and wow. Even when he loses it, he scores. Way to stay with it. Broncos up by one.
Well, Coach Ball is highly upset right now, went over his zone and some of the rotations and the stop penetration, and for him to walk down the lane, I know he's extremely upset. Another turnover by the Vikings.
It's going to be a substitution. Marquise Crutchfield comes in the game.
And for the Vikings, number 21, Shaquise Daniels.
Y'all didn't mention on this. Viking team's on a four-game winning streak. I mean, they're rolling.
Absolutely.
They beat every CIAA team this year they played.
So the Broncos could get a win here tonight. It would be a great win.
No question. It's a very good basketball team. Boston Protégés, they extremely well coached. Does a great job teaching like a defensive. Wow. Genius.
Richmond, that gives him a total of 11. 14
points. Finally, I was saying, they call turnovers, they build a transition and attack the basket. They're explosive.
That's some
You talked a little earlier, you don't beat a Division I team after they played. They were up 20 one time. This team has ability.
Absolutely.
It's going to be a scary team coming down the stretch.
And the game's getting intense between Omar Roberts and Joshua Bryant. They're doing a little talking.
They're competing. Ooh,
absolutely.
Again, unbelievable.
Wow.
This scared me down the middle of the lane. I know right now, Broncos not at all happy on that. But that's the game of basketball, solve issues. Problem solving, many problems.
Definitely. Joshua Bryant right now is just in the zone. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that's not supposed to happen.
Not at all. He's your leader, and Coach talked about it, but and that's why he's talking, equate the cooking, taking the time. You know, we didn't have Josh Bryant in the first part of the semester.
Yep. So
Spencer is just, you know, gathering talent. Now, we add him and Rich, this is the whole different basketball team. You can't even talk about the record before those two gentlemen have joined the team.
Absolutely.
Our next contestant.
But Coach Walker definitely yesterday, he went over that, how to guard that penetration. And he's going to have an aggressive counting session over there on the sideline.
With Broncos up by six now, man. And it's all led by Joshua Bryan and Jaquel Richmond, those two guys that we have missing the earlier game.
The winner of the Broncos fan.
That's when you got to play with emotion, but you got to combat that with composure. You can't be super hard in 45 minutes. You're up by 10, and it's not over. And if you're down, you can't be down. So you got to keep playing, be consistent, and execute the game plan.
Yep.
Game of
and it's easy. Also important to note that Dr. Bryan is leading right now in scoring.
Okay.
And the game for both teams is 15. And Square Richmond right behind them with 14. Those two guys are definitely making a difference. I love what I'm seeing. If the Broncos can keep this up and are able to walk out of here with a W and continue to build off this throughout the season, it's going to be a great bounce back season for them, because right now they're 2-9.
Well, they got a big momentum. I told you, change it just, you know, in their mindset with this team that's assembled. They're 1-0.
Yeah,
first
20,
time they played together in the backcourt was against UNC Asheville. So it's all your perception. Execution.
The Vikings caught the Broncos sleeping on that play.
Well, anytime you come out of a timeout and score a basket, that says a lot about your coaching and execution.
Richmond wants to set up the offense.
Yeah, he definitely a floor general. He's a difference maker.
You can see the movement in the Broncos, too. They're not just standing there, hosk up for three. No good.
That's a miss, but a great, great play call.
Ball's out of bounds. Possession remains to the Broncos. Media timeout.
Take a media timeout, under 15. Right now, also, while we have a moment, the National Guard is a proud sponsor of Fayetteville State Athletics, always ready, always there. The National Guard continues its historic dual mission, providing trained units to the states, territories, and the District of Columbia, and keeping itself equipped to protect life and property. The Guard also provides trained units to the nation equipped and ready to defend the United States and its interests all over the globe. Visit www.nationalguard.com for more information on the National Guard. 14-10 remaining in the game. The Broncos are up by 4, 51-47. Definitely seeing this turnaround coming at the end of the first half, and the Broncos are definitely continue to build on that. Had a fight from the Vikings a little bit already.
Well, high-level basketball game in the first half. A lot of times I'm coming out of break from Christmas and just trying to fill each other out and smooth out everything. But you saw this half is much better, well played. Both ends, executing, finishing. So, good coaches, good programs, the better they get to come.
Absolutely.
I tell you what, this facility-wise, just looking around in Cape Arena, this is an outstanding facility, always has been, but a great job by the head. Dr. Anderson, Anthony Bennett, athletic director, his staff to improve it. This is absolutely beautiful. This floor, we talked about redone, and I see one of my mentors up there, Felton J. Capel Jr., late, my heart.
A legend.
Up here as well. It's a blessing to see him up there. I know he'd be proud.
Absolutely.
Can't be a better place in the state, in this level, in Fayetteville State, as far as facility-wise. Can be.
Definitely can, especially in the CIAA. You see a lot of those other facilities.
Well,
not
the CIAA, SA, SWAG, I'm thinking this is a beautiful facility for a low level.
And I love the turnout. Even though the students are not here, it's definitely a great turnout for the Broncos.
It is. Sometimes it's tough, you know, when the kids are gone because they're the backbone.
Yeah.
Good pass. The Hop kids impressive.
And a foul has been called.
Bronco foul on number 21, Giles Webster. That's his fourth, team third.
The Broncos still doing a good job of creating turnovers. John the Vikings are at 15 now, at half 13, so I guess they've improved slightly, but that's been a calling call for them, and Fayetteville State is doing a much better job taking care of the ball themselves.
Substitution into the game for the Broncos,
being explosive and attacking the paint themselves.
And you look at it, yeah, Denzel Hodge with two steals, Josh Bryant has two steals, Jaquel Richmond has one.
And a major stat that allowed Fayetteville State to get back into this game and take the lead is they have scored 17 points off Viking turnovers.
Wow. And if you think about how many offensive rebounds the Vikings have gotten, they only have 8 second chance points.
Yes. A lot of a plethora of different ingredients to being successful. Nice brush screen, little drive action, attack the basket. Now Fayetteville State's doing a good job of getting that paint.
Yeah.
Vikings foul on number 1, John Mader. That's his fourth. Team third.
They call that a shooting foul, okay.
On the line, shooting 2 for the Broncos, number 13, Mark Burton.
From Tokyo, Japan, going to the line for 2. A terrific free throw shooter. The first one is up, and it is good.
To the game for the Vikings, number 21, Shaheen Petaway.
Both of these teams from three-point line are shooting extremely well, 42%. 43 for the Broncos, 50% for the Vikings. Side basketball game.
Burton knocks down both free throws. That's a great
matchup time. Matchup zone, 1-2-2. Matchup zone action. Love the pace at which the Vikings offensively move the basketball and cut.
A floater, a strong finish from number 30.
Mendez in talking. Coach yesterday, he's a guy that this is his first game playing.
Really?
Yeah, so a lot of pieces being put together by both programs. These are going to be two good teams come March.
And great help side defense from Byers.
The good thing was he blocked the shot and he kept it in play.
A hard foul on Will Brown.
Foul on number 45, Will Brown.
Is on the floor.
That's
hopefully
his first.
He's okay.
Team four.
Gets back up. Feel like he's okay.
On the line shooting two for the Vikings, number 21, Shai Petaway.
When you see a player hit the floor like that, you just hope it's nothing serious. Hope he's just able to bounce back up. So that's a great sign.
No question. All in the same Shadow Blade family.
Yes.
It's going to be a nail biter. No question about it.
Petaway knocks down the first free throw. Second one is up, and it is no good.
Well, you know, one thing about missed free throws, coaches allude to that you can't get in your press if that's what you want to do. So it's so critical. Easy part of the game. Oh, he's good at the ball. He is crafty and creative. Coming off that ball screen.
That's his second team four.
And also, UNC Wilmington, from my understanding, he was recruited by Kevin Keats, who's now with NC State. So. That says a lot about his ability.
Into the game for the Vikings, number five, Shaquif Daniels.
Definitely, Kevin Keats is definitely doing a great job with NC State.
Doing outstanding, so he puts a stamp on you. That says something about it. Happy to have him.
Absolutely.
Love his zone defense by the Vikings.
What's that, a 3-2? What was that defense? Three.
As a matchup.
Areas
kind of more to adjust to the offensive movement. A great set by Fayetteville State. Coach Spencer does a good job, always has here back in Marlboro County and St. Augustine's College, and of executing effectively. Does a great job of that. These teams always have. Good trap in the corner.
Timeout. Had no other choice. Great defense by the Broncos. The Broncos are up by five. 56-51 over the Vikings right now with 12:04 remaining in the game.
When they create turnovers, just have it because they turn immediately to points.
Absolutely.
They fly. And I guess Broncos can't fly, but, you know, if they could, they're flying Broncos.
Put some wings on them, man.
Yeah, some wings. I'm a little hungry now. Don't say that word more than twice because I'm talking about wings and my barbecue and lemon pepper.
Oh, yeah. You want barbecue, lemon pepper together, or you want
I'm just thinking of variety. You said wings, it triggers.
No problem. Lemon pepper is definitely the thing, though, man. You go to one of these wing spots, you will get a, I do get the honey barbecue, lemon pepper together, man. It's a great thing if you never had it.
I think I'll be heading there shortly.
Love.
I tell you, see Mr. Ray Thomas down there, elite professional, one of the best in the business.
Absolutely.
And he's just a cornerstone of this institution. What he's done with these young people, the
marketing
and advertising, no question.
Traveling
star.
As it goes to the Broncos.
Yes, definitely is.
High quality performance tonight. A lot of people here. Let me cut you off. Agent first, another giant in this profession.
Absolutely.
He's just, the best setup late period when it comes to production, and he's just elevated Fayetteville State to a championship level with all programs.
Love what they're doing here. This is something that we tried to get started a long time ago. I know you remember that.
I do, no question. The first thing to do it.
And a three from Richmond is no good. The Vikings come down with the rebound.
Well, this game is kind of mirroring last game. It says it was a close game. They played each other not too long ago.
Three.
Back and forth.
Shaquie Daniels.
But he changed the defenses, Coach Walker is. Pretty impressive both ends. The chess games that both these guys are playing. Ball screen coverage, rotations, and isolations offensively.
Will Brown definitely has to have his hands ready for that.
A nice dunk down.
Yeah.
Saw Coach Ray broadening here, working with the big guys and teaching those guys. And on the line shooting nice to see guys growing their careers. Will Brown. And McCain doing the same thing with the perimeter guys.
One thing I would love to see from Will Brown is going to the rim more aggressively. He missed the first free throw.
Nice touch. And that'll come. Out of time, getting the ball in position, being ready athletically, and kind of caught the ball in a great position, but wasn't in a place where he could elevate and explode on balance. A lot of times, it's when you catch the ball and how you catch it. But aggressive comes up sometimes with this being mature. He has a nice touch, though. Great potential. He's going to be a good player.
Absolutely. And that free throw puts the Broncos up by 3, 57-54 over the Vikings.
Both teams are kind of in the matchup zone a little bit and kind of adjusting. 1-2-2 and 2-3.
Yeah, I love that. And that shows the communication on defense as well. And confuses the offense. Hard pass by Byers. This is a good idea.
Good idea. What they say, operation success, patient died.
Oh. I like that. I have to use that one.
A lot of times you want a big guy in the paint just go up and shoot the basketball. But he's a skilled kid.
Yes, he is.
We're trying to isolate Josh LeBron in the box. Another ball screen motion. Good slip. Turned the corner in the paint.
Good block. Byers.
Sapa coming down to 6. In the corner, the shooter.
Definitely should have thought he should have taken that shot. Josh Bryant with a 3, and it's good at the buzzer. Josh Bryant doing that 3, Lance, that Lance Stevenson.
He start dancing, playing the guitar. Make him dance, Lance.
Hobbs up for a 3, no good. Byers with the rebound and gets fouled by Will Brown.
I'll tell you what, you see the intense in the coach's faces as intense as the players.
Yeah.
Ready to get his stand to go out there and block out himself.
That's 6 rebounds from Byers as well.
Yeah, he's in back. Brown's right there, got to get him out though. They get him out.
Absolutely. And while they take a media timeout, you can be ahead of the game and purchase your 2019 CIAA basketball tournament tickets from the Fayetteville State University ticket office. You're invited to the CIAA's most anticipated event. Tickets for the 2019 CIAA men's and women's basketball tournament are on sale right now at Fayetteville State University ticket office. The annual event will once again be held in Charlotte, North Carolina from February 25th to March 2nd, 2019. That's an event that we are definitely looking forward to. We'll be there representing for the Broncos. Hopefully we're there all the way to Saturday.
I tell you another thing that people don't understand. You talk about the sprint to break over Christmas. Time with no class and a lot of progress being made. A lot of guys transferring in or becoming eligible, but that's a great teaching time. So it's really hard to try to have a viewpoint on the team before that break as it comes after, because I'm looking at the Fayetteville State team. A lot of improvements. Guys have improved dramatically. Same in the ECSU. So that gap during the Christmas break can really propel you to the next phase of the CIAA conference play.
Absolutely.
At the same time, some teams can kind of go backwards. But really, it's a time of growth. And I've watched Fayetteville State practice, did a good job of really improving. It's a mile, not a sprint.
Absolutely.
With no rings hand out on yesterday. Now the Vikings have continued to win the battle of the boards, 30-19. But again, Fayetteville State's trademark, they continue to score 20 points off Viking turnovers. So we're jockeying that back and forth. The rebounding battle and the turnover battle.
Exactly.
If everyone solves that, we'll have an opportunity to be successful. And Josh Bryant has caught fire, 7-for-11, 18 points, hitting threes, dancing like Lance. That's what good players do. Impact the game.
Tazay Byers knocks down both free throws. Brings his total points to 11.
Yes. He's been impactful. A lot of times you can keep the stat of shot blocking, but he's shot changing as well.
Yes. And he's doing this all off the bench as well, too. Burton up for a 3. No good. Way to stay with it for Josh Bryant.
Good job by the Broncos making the possession.
9:20 remaining in the game.
With that continuity offense, with ball screen motion, ball's going from side to side, and he's trying to find a crack. It's good rotation by the Vikings. Good rotation. Now Josh Bryant fouled.
Bronco foul on number 20, Joshua Bryant.
Okay, he's only second.
Team six.
That's a team six foul.
Both teams did a good job defensively thus far without getting in the bonus early. And that was an appropriate foul. The guy was attacking the basket. And Coach Walker is excited about Hobbs getting healthy again. Really has some options in his backcourt, Faison and Hobbs.
Hobbs goes for the second free throw attempt, and it's up, and it is good. Brings the Vikings within two.
And I think free throw shooting is going to be a big impact on both teams closing this game.
Balls out of bounds. Well, it goes to the Vikings.
Richmond gives the ball out of bounds. Got a little out of control out there. Looking.
1-4 set.
Three is rims out. That was almost at the bottom of that one.
That 1-4 set for the Vikings, real hard to guard. You have that many players at proximity, so it's an impressive set by Sean Walker. Really enjoy this kind of the offense by the Broncos. Very disciplined and impressed with the execution.
Richmond up for three. That one rimmed out.
Back to back, in and out threes for both teams. Offensive. Got a foul. You know, you got to be disturbed with that. You don't like guys to foul, but he's being aggressive and showing a glimpse. So sometimes you have to kind of accept that.
Substitution into the game for the Broncos, number 21.
Giles Webster will come back into the game. He has to be careful. He has four fouls.
Okay. Nice luxury Coach Spencer has. Diverse type of big, 6'11", long and athletic. Brown, and you bring in another big number 21. Webster is more stocky and physical.
Mm-hmm. And more offensively gifted as well, too.
Yes, and you got to have the balance. But I'm looking forward moving to see these both these teams play this year because I think they're going to surprise some people.
Absolutely. With this revamped Broncos offense, man.
Talking about 2-9 failed with State, that's really a false statement. This team is 1-0. The 2-9, the team went all the way together. Bryant didn't play, nor did the point guard. And these guys are difference makers.
And those free throws ties the game up. It's 60-60 with 8:21 remaining. And Haas goes to the rack strong, gets fouled.
He's such an elite shooter. He has so much range. The team respects his three-point shot so much. If he shows a ball, the whole gym will jump and the lane will open up. So that's a great – a ball fake for him is a great weapon.
I think I've seen you jump a little bit, Coach. Did you nudge a little bit? Did you bite on that pump fake?
I did.
For the line for the Broncos, number 10,
got about
Denzel
an inch or two up on my seat. That's the – luxury of having shooters. They space the floor and they make them faster.
And Haas knocks down both.
Into the game for the Broncos.
Well, he's due. I mean, he hasn't shot the ball well. Very impressed with him, though. Not an opportunity, but he continues to compete defensively and execute. And that shows a culture of winning. When other guys are scoring, you're not. You're still playing and it doesn't bother you as far as your effort and attitude.
Absolutely.
Man to man by the Broncos now. And going back and forth this game with matchup zone and man-to-man. Switch the ball screen. Oh, nice move by Hobbs.
Zacchaeus Hobbs.
Feel like he had a free ticket. Delta on that flight.
It sure did. And Coach Spencer wanted him to switch. As we talked to Brian coming down the floor. Always teaching.
Vikings foul number two, Justin Faison. That's his third team.
That's Justin Faison's third foul. Broncos are going to the line for a 1-1.
But Coach Spencer really did
a great job of navigating this game up the lead. Now it's a tie game. So I really think these free throws coming down the last 7:52, both teams in the bonus is going to dictate the outcome.
Right. It definitely will. And at this point, it's very imperative for the Broncos to continue to knock down these free throws. They've been doing well this second half.
Coach Walker, I hear him. He's not excited about the foul being called. He thinks a lot of contact going on. So both he and Coach Spencer are really working the ref and teaching their team. They got a lot going on. These head coaches in college, they do so much. Another turnover.
Great hands by Crutchfield.
And also these turns are live turnovers.
Three wow. is good three. From the corner. Knockdown.
Murray State gets a turnover. They're explosive in transition.
I love the confidence that Mark Burton has. He shot that three like he was wide open by himself with nobody else on the court with him. Faison pull-up jumper. No good. Rebound for Josh Bryant.
The five-point run, the free throws, turnovers, and the three-point. Side ball screen.
Find Burton again.
Josh Bryant is so tough to guard.
Byers had to adjust his shot.
Oh, another turnover.
And they called. Oh, they called traveling on Richmond.
That goes to the Vikings.
I tell you, Fable State's done a better job of rebounding the basketball compared to Little City State not turning the ball over. They both have work to do, but I think those are the two catalysts impact actions that both need to solve to win this basketball game. If I can take care of the basketball, Fable State rebound that basketball. Side ball screen.
off his foot.
Good job by the point guard, Richmond, really to guard and kind of negate that ball screen action.
Great defense without fouling.
It is. Yeah, he's a difference maker.
Burton looks for Haas. Look for Burton to get him off. Burton is doing a great job tonight.
I'm really impressed by him outside of shooting the basketball with range. He feels the ball, attacking the basket, get off the bounce, create some offense.
He's definitely not one of those. He's not your normal bench player. He was starting the majority of this season.
Yeah.
First part of the season and shot well. Right now, he has that free throw gives him 18 points, and he's knocked down five three pointers, five for nine from 3-point land too.
And once you shoot the basketball like that, people respect you. When it's hard to guard, you got to close out.
Oh yeah.
But looking at the Vikings, they're a big time front court, 6'11 and 6'8, and Broncos are going small, so it's a matter of style and see which one to prevail. Broncos are playing four guards right now.
And three is up. No good.
He's a beast down there.
Petway
with the offensive rebound and score brings the Vikings within five. Broncos are up 69-64.
Long at 6'6 on the wing for the Vikings. 6'11, 6'8. They're playing the zone and negate that speed by the Broncos. Got four explosive guards out there.
Brian again, see if he can beat the shot clock. No good. The corner three from Petway. Three is good.
As far as pitching the ball ahead. The Vikings kind of do a little, they pitch the ball ahead with quickness, and the Broncos just attack off the bounce. 2-point basketball game.
That three gave Petway 16 points.
Yes.
He's 3-for-5 from the 3-point land as well, too.
Coach Spencer's team always did a good job of being patient running their offense.
High scuff for three, no good.
The shots need to be made in crunch time, but as important, that paint opportunities and free throws are more reliable. Another good shot.
Take it
to the ball. Not a timeout.
Media timeout.
4:54 left, tie basketball game.
Yeah, man, this is a nail biter right here. It's going down to the wire for sure.
It's an evenly matched game as far as play. Both teams kind of play to their strengths. Both teams in the bonus. High basketball game. Looking in any major foul trouble. Manor has four, for the Vikings.
Let's go, Jason.
Webster has four for the Broncos. So that's going to be something to look at. And, but now it's test time. These coaches are trying to give these guys more than one look. This is what we're doing offensively, on defensively. And man, we're in this. If you're in zone, we're in this. Be aware of the isolation. LeBron, be aware of the big ECSU. So a lot of dialogue is going on. Now, as timeout becomes critical, they give you a play ahead of two. And we need to be done to close this game.
Absolutely. Broncos can do it. They've been creating turnovers the entire game. I believe they will create more. I don't see why that would change at this point in time, in juncture in the game.
In closing time, it's real simplistic. It's executing, taking care of the basketball, and making free throws.
Absolutely. And if they bring in Giles Webster back in the game, they're definitely being careful with him. With four personal fouls already.
Stats coming in down the stretch. You talk about Lincoln State still up 35-22 in the rebounding total. But points off turnovers are just extremely painful for the Vikings to fail to say. That's 25 points. That's an enormous percentage.
I think you'll see a lot of Josh Bryan and Jaquel Richmond with the ball.
Yes, and matchup zone. Lincoln City State. They have a unique rotation and switching off. Oh, good shot, opportunity. It's a miss. Great offensive board by the Broncos.
Want to get a new shot. The shot clock game changed, though. They did hit rim, right?
It did. I know so they saw that.
That's a three from Haas. No good.
Good shot.
Haas is not shooting well tonight, but that's one of those shots that you will live with when it comes to Haas. You want him to keep shooting. Three is up, and it's good.
That's a big-time shot right there.
Gives the Vikings a three-point lead.
We talk about all the schemes, but there's something called players making plays that's going to sit there and creep up, and that's a player making a play. He is so good off the dribble.
Absolutely. The Vikings have definitely turned up their defensive intensity.
Mark Barton's coming in. Now, you know, he's definitely a viable three-point shooter, a threat. So now Coach Spencer has four perimeter scorers out there, which is a matchup issue and a big. So
great
job. Coach Walker kind of coming to the same thing and rotated to meet him. Two good coaches out here. Deciding to watch this chess matchup.
Love what I see him right here.
Ball screen action.
He's shot is good.
The basket for Jaquel Richmond.
That shot right there by Richmond brings the Broncos within one. 3:15 remaining in the game.
Execution gets real simple. Players making plays, run your stuff.
You gotta watch the back door.
Double dribble.
I'll definitely double dribble, and another three by Maynard.
Good defense. It's good play making the play.
That gives Maynard 9 points right there. Back to back threes for Maynard. Puts the Vikings up by four. Looking for Burton. Vikings not allowing it though. Watch the corner. Oh, too high of a pass.
Get out there.
The Vikings get the possession.
But Coach Walker just subbing in defensive offense right now. Put his big 22 sub in. To check in for defensive purposes and Allen and to come back out. So you see both teams kind of get their schemes together. good basketball.
The National Guard is a proud sponsor of the players making plays. Always ready, always
teams
fair.
Have depth.
The National Guard continues this historic
obviously, not only one team can win this game.
No.
Moving forward, they're going to be definitely a problem in their divisions. The Southern Division players coming up shortly, as well as Northern
Board,
ECSU.
To units to the nation equipped and ready to defend the United States.
I think the rebounding numbers, as far as offensively, offensive rebounds is what's killing the Broncos right now. That's what's keeping or has kept the Vikings in the game.
Well, and then on the other end, I think what's so impressive to me is how explosive Fayetteville State is after turnovers. You're talking about 20 points a game.
Right.
But all that being said, 4 points.
Yeah. Something has to offset at some point, right?
Exactly.
With 2:34 remaining in the game, the Broncos are down 71-75 to the Elizabeth City State University Vikings.
No dribble handoff. Oh. Dribble handoff to get some clock now. They're being precise and being persistent to make sure they take care of the Coach Walker's very upset. This must have been a miscue in execution. Look like
that's six remaining in the shot clock.
Ooh, good help.
And Hobbs looking up to Richmond.
So good in transition. That turnover. That's 22 points now in transition off turnovers.
Denzel Hoss has three steals now.
Now defensive change by the Broncos. They go to man defense. As
they're talking.
As
I love the communication.
No question. They're switching the ball screen. Under 10. Now you want time, but at the same time, with the quality shot.
Standing in front. 3 seconds remaining in the shot clock. Hobbs with a shot. The three is up, and it's no good. Oh, offensive rebound. And he traveled.
I tell you,
the Broncos get bailed out.
This is over. These turnovers are really mounting up. You had it's just a microcosm of the game. You had offensive rebound. They weren't given up by the Broncos again, but a turnover by the Vikings. So.
Joseph Allen.
2-point basketball game.
1:26 remaining.
To the Broncos game,
have the ball.
Number 21, Charles Webster.
A lot of these plays for both teams have been self-inflicted.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, it's a good team to play against. A lot of times you want to nullify the mistakes you make that were options that you had other ways to go. Zones, a matchup zone here. A lot of length down there. Big front court. Skill lineup for the Broncos.
Looking at 10 on the shot clock.
Nice pass.
At the corner three is Josh Bryan, and it's good.
Josh
Bryan. Josh Bryan.
See the bench over there, staff. See the excitement Coach Broughton over there and Coach McCain just echoing the call and being on the same page defensively.
Foul on number 13, Mark Bird. That's his first team.
I've seen a lot of stuff happening
on the line,
less than
shooting
a minute.
Two for the Vikings, number 20, Tyjae Byers. Vikings, number 13, Omar Roberts.
It's a big free throw by a big under a minute left. A lot of pressure. That's a big time free throw. A lot of touch by the big kid. That's impressive.
It is.
All right, get a little clock now. They throw three-quarter court. Token pressure. Train defense back into their matchup zone.
Timeout taken by the Broncos. Make sure you purchase your 2018 CIAA basketball tournament tickets from the Fayetteville State University ticket office. The tournament will be played
under
the Coliseum and
the
Spectrum Center.
Timeout. You really have to give your team a plan.
$200
for just in the head. Let them know now on the made basket, we're in this. If you miss, we're in this defense. All these things are going on. So got to be effective listeners and players being and locked in. You can't let emotion take you. So I'm pretty sure Coach Jim Deacon for the make and for the miss. And Justin Lyons, who's our best defensive team right now? Who's our best free throw shooting team right now?
Yeah.
How many timeouts do we have? All that going on. So this is the fun part of the game. All the preparation kind of it showcases itself now.
Seconds remaining in the game. Broncos are down by one to the Vikings, 76-77.
Well played game. Good scoring.
Yeah.
Close next point. Fast. Exciting threes.
Definitely an exciting one.
It is. Execution of the team. A lot of turnovers, but at the same time, and it has been much better than the first. Also, it's important. Where's the ball inbounding from? That's so critical. That kind of affects your offensive play you call. It affects what defense you're in.
Absolutely.
The right first horn is going to get out there. Side of the bounce.
Definitely had to get those players out there.
No question. 19 seconds shot clock. Plenty of time to get a quality shot.
Ryan right there. Oh, too easy for him. And good layup by Joshua Bryant. It's Joshua Bryant, 23 points.
He caught the ball riding the paint and attacked the basket. A breakdown there, but a big-time play by a big-time player.
Hands got to be ready.
Fun time now.
Three is up. Wow!
Unbelievable.
By Maynard.
Unbelievable.
Three.
Big time shot.
Maynard has made three straight three-pointers, and you can't be mad at that defense.
No question. Good defense. That has players making play out of Rayford, North Carolina. Hometown guy coming home for the break.
Absolutely.
Big time shot. He shot that from Rayford.
You know he did, right?
And that's why this defense is so fickle.
Yeah.
Good defensive call by Coach Spencer in the right place, just an NBA three.
Yeah.
No one's fault. Come back to the same thing.
Yeah.
And likewise, big time shot by Joshua Bryant. It makes it fun. Players making plays. 2-point game, 12 seconds to go. I'm interested to see what defense that the Vikings are in. Deshaun Watt comes out, and offensively, Coach Spencer has to give him a play. For a man zone, for a man,
yep.
And for a zone defense. Has to give them an action on the miss and on the make. On the miss, who do you foul, when do you foul? Insane defensively, Sean walks over there trying to say, who cannot get the shot? Make sure Josh Bryant does not beat us.
Right.
These guys don't get enough credit for all the preparation that's involved in these moments.
This is a great game. Man.
Outstanding game.
This is a great game.
Evenly matched. 8-8 from the fouls in the bonus. 2-point game. Both elite players on both sides are stepping up.
And that shot from Maynard, man. Even though he's playing for another team, you like to see the hometown kid come back and say, what's up to Fayetteville? That's what he did. Yeah, that's what he did. I can't be mad at that competitiveness.
Again, regardless of who wins this game, these are two quality basketball teams in the CIAA. You'll be heard. They'll be heard from come tournament time.
Absolutely. The 10 seconds left in the game.
And what you're doing is give up a three.
Out of ball is turn out over. Of bounds. Turn
gotta,
over.
Got to deny everything.
Got to
deny everything. Get a 5-second count.
Substitution into the game for the Vikings, number 13.
Got to deny, get your head, got to deny the ball, get a count, and then immediate foul, plenty of time. Ironically, I won a game here with an 80-footer against Sean Walker years ago. I don't flash. Okay, 3.2.
Yeah.
Broncos foul number 21.
Got to stay composed. Stay locked in.
Fifth personal foul.
I've seen him plenty of time.
And right now, while we have a break, too, I'd like to also mention that don't go anywhere from the Fayetteville State Broncos network, because we have the Lady Broncos of Fayetteville State University going against the Salem University Tigers coming up next right after this game. you don't want to miss that game either. The Lady Broncos coming off a win.
A big win. Impressive.
Into the game for the Broncos, number 33,
on my birthday, so I really enjoyed it.
Oh, happy belated, man.
That's no problem.
How old are you now, 22?
I'm 27.
27, my fault.
Give or take 15 years.
Okay, got you. Byers just knocked down.
I graduated in 98. You already cowed the bag. Okay.
You graduated in 98?
I sure did.
Oh, man.
You talk about three-point games. It's big right here, obviously. If he misses free throw, got a timeout to call, inbound play.
And way to knock down the free throws.
Hit it three, get it. Yeah, you got to play. I mean, I've seen players make fouls and make plays and work. The smartest, so that play through it. And also, we hate to say it, we're still playing for the next possession. So, win or lose, you can run a play with 3 seconds or 2.4, whatever it is, and you may not win this game, but you'll see this situation again. So you always want to win, no doubt about it, but you want to improve, and you never know. You'll be situation, tournament time, conference time, where it's a four-point game, a three-point game, got to grow.
Absolutely. Great doing this game with you, though.
Like I said, your presence on mine. You're a quality basketball player, you're a quality institution.
And then when you have a great basketball mind right beside you that knows what he's talking about, it makes the job a lot easier.
I'll tell you what, I won't even charge you for that. I appreciate
it. I mean, I have the luxury of having the coach of the year right beside me. So, you know, I make sure I take advantage of it.
I'll tell you what, you're doing an outstanding job yourself, and I won't charge you for that. I might have to give you a finder fee.
Appreciate you.
Now,
appreciate
also to happen, I mean, four-point game, it seems that, but fouls have occurred, situations have happened, so. There's something going on.
With the shot clock, they put 30 seconds.
Okay.
They put 30 seconds on the shot clock.
Coach Walker's telling the team it's a play. Don't get unfocused. Well, Spencer has a great play drawn up. You know, I talk about the twin the basketball game effectively. You have so many integral parts, scores table, announcing. Right now, a little play-by-play with organization, officials, game management, the lights, the whole nine, the music. So. A lot of people invested in making this a quality product. This has been a great game, outstanding game.
And that'll do it.
And that's the
Broncos,
game.
Unfortunately, take the L in this game to the Vikings, 78-82. Great game, though.
Outstanding game. The Vikings were hot on a four-game winning streak, and this is a new team for the Broncos. Didn't get it tonight, but I promise you this, moving forward, wins will come in droves.
Absolutely. With this loss, the Broncos go to 2-10 and 0-4 in the conference. Like you said, though, it's a new team. They'll get better at this. Real quick, leading the game for the whole game was Josh Bryant for the Broncos with 23. And leading the way for the Elizabeth City State University Vikings was Tajay Byers, actually, off the bench with 17-8. Great game from both. Great doing this game from you live from the Felton J. Capel Arena. We'll see you next time for Travis Bledsoe and the coach, Alfonso T. We'll see you next time. We're out.